What is it that made Paul Gascoigne such an important and special footballer?
His personality, on and off the pitch, his ability to beat players in an old-fashioned way in terms of how he played, dribbling past opponents, scoring goals with head and foot. He was a versatile player, and that's an understatement because he could do everything. And I think the other thing was he became a kind of cult hero with the English supporters, particularly with the Tottenham supporters when he was there and Newcastle, and of course later on Rangers and Lazio. I mean, he had the most amazing CV by the time he'd finished, and that doesn't account for the amount of time he was out injured, which of course was considerable. But no, it was. I use the word personality because I think Gazza, if you turn the clock back to the early 90s, I think you'd have to say that Gazza was the outstanding football character in this country, and I don't think there was an English player I ever saw who was better over the years that he played.
And he was responsible for so many iconic moments on the pitch. Is there one that is the most precious, the most special to you personally?
Well, I don't know about me personally. I think for most people it would be Euro 96 and the goal he scored against Scotland. I did a cup tie, which nobody else will remember apart from Tottenham fans, in the fourth round of the FA Cup in 1991. And the game had almost gone so cold that nothing was going on the pitch. Spurs were winning, but there wasn't much in it. And then Gazza suddenly picked the ball up, and out of nothing, he beat three men and scored. And the whole stadium just rose as one, and it completely transformed the afternoon. And that's my favourite one, because I was actually doing the commentary at the time and telling everybody how boring the game had become. And this is Gascoigne, and everything changed, as it usually did when Gazza got on the ball.
Paul's triumphs on the pitch were obviously in tandem with a lot of tragedy off the pitch. And this is a documentary that really explores that side of his life and the ordeals that he went through, particularly with the media and other challenges. Do you think that it's important for us to explore some of the negative culture that surrounds football?
You don't have Gazza without the warts, do you? I mean, he had a checkered career in many ways. You've correctly identified that, and I'm sure what we're going to see in this film is the best of Gazza and probably the darker moments as well. But that's because it will tell the whole story, and it will be completely authentic. But I tell you what, at the end of it, he will come out of it the hero that he always is for me.